Sam Day. I'm from Portland, Oregon, and I'm 15 years old. When I was 9 years old, I was diagnosed with cancer. Then in March 4th of 2011, I had my leg amputated. A year or two later, the cancer came back, and I had half of my foot amputated. In 2014, the cancer came back again, and I'm currently fighting cancer in my lungs. I love to surf. I love to swim. Those are probably my favorite things. I love being active because it helps me be able to keep up with my friends. They can be a good escape.
So the Junior Seau Foundation Adaptive Surf Program was set out to bring people all over and have a common goal of just learn how to surf. We want to give them the tools and resources to be the best athlete that they can be. And every kid is getting something different out of the program. And we hope that's joy, and we hope that's learning, and we hope that, you know, this sport of surfing or any sport they pursue will change their life.
Surfing is pretty much what makes my world go around, and it's my passion in life, so to be able to share my passion today with these children and to see all the happiness that it brought them basically made my heart melt. It was amazing.
I was so excited when I heard about this because I love to surf, and so, you know, I heard about this big surfing program, so I'm like, oh, I gotta do that. Trip down was easy, and everything's just been great so far.
So at Challenge Athletes Foundation, we're all about empowering the athletes and making them be able to do whatever they want, getting them stoked on the whole environment of surfing and the culture and get out there and have a good time.
Well, going into the program, I wasn't super great at surfing, but now I've improved a lot, basically. I mean, I'm not pro champion level yet, but I'm definitely way better than I was.
You know, we started off, Sam was a little nervous. He was kind of a little bit hesitant. First wave I decided to push him into. I don't know why, but I didn't go with him, and I pushed him in, and he purled and just ate it like really bad. And I'm like, dude, you just got the hard part out of the way, you know? I'm like, dude, I want to catch a wave with you. Like, I want to stand up with you. Let's go out the back, catch one of those waves. And he was like,
let's do it. So we go out, we go way out, and we catch this huge wave, and we start coming in. I hear the crowd cheering. I look behind me and he's standing up with me, and oh man, it was surreal. It was just awesome. I was so just happy.
Just from the beginning of our session to the end of our session, you know, I watched Sam's mentality just totally flip-flop. Where at the beginning he was a little bit shy and nervous, and by the end he was beaming and so fired up and stoked and just being out there and sloshed around and taking a few waves in the face, riding waves and the feeling of just dropping in, and I don't know, it's just, you can't really put it into words.
It's one of the best things you'll ever do. It's one of the best experiences I've ever had. Just when you finally catch that one good wave, it feels so good, you know? It's just awesome.
If you knew Sam, you know that he had a huge spirit. And he did, and it had an impact on everyone around him. But that spirit needed to be nurtured as well. And there was a time early on when Sam was first diagnosed that he went to a dark place. We felt like we were going to keep Sam, but we weren't sure if we would keep his spirit. What CAF has done was nurtured his spirit and put a smile on his face. I know people here would say that Sam's spirit had an effect on this community, but I would say that this community really protected and built up Sam's spirit. I would say that this community nurtured Sam's spirit in a way that our family couldn't, and I'm incredibly grateful for that.